side, the car starts with a strong and smooth front end theme, and it's anchored by a six-sided Kia grille. This is the EX, so it uses chrome crossbar highlights. It also has these fog lights built into the front fascia. On the outside, of course, are 17-inch aluminum wheels with Michelin tires. And we like the Ronto for a variety of reasons, one of which is its proportions. And they're marked by a long wheelbase, short overhang proportion. And also, you notice on the side, there's a very European feel to the shape of the sheet metal. One of the things we've also designed into the car is a comparatively low belt line, which provides good visibility, and combined with the mirrors, gives excellent visibility for what the car is supposed to be. This car is an EX also. It's fitted with these roof rails, and again, chrome highlights on the door handle and the belt line moldings. As we work our way toward the back, you'll notice that this has a sophisticated inclined shape to the rear quarter glass. We work our way around, and again, we got the details right in terms of the shape and the detailing of the taillights. And then, of course, in the back, we've got a very sporty theme, and you can see that the car's athletic stance is enhanced by the wheels out to the corner and a little bit by the squarish shape of the gate here. We've taken a nice detail, the hatch release, and we've put it here. It's hidden out of the way real clean for an easy-to-open gate. Plenty of room in the back area for stuff. This vehicle also has the 50-50 split-fold third seat, and it's easily operated. Just pull the lever, give it a tug up, and away you go. And conversely, if you want to put it away, just pull the lever. So it provides for a very handy, versatile third row seat for customers who want that option. As we work our way to the front, first thing we notice when we get in the car is the hip point, which is set for very good ingress egress, and it's the same height front and rear, so getting in and out of the vehicle is really quite easy. And the driving position is a little bit elevated versus a sedan, and as I'm saying, that the Ronto crosses between sport utility vehicles and sedans and a little bit of some minivan function. Once we're inside, we have a very, very well executed ergonomic layout. The primary and secondary controls all fall to your fingertips. In fact, the steering wheel audio controls are easily used by the thumb here. And the shifter is just at the right position. So it's not on the center console on the floor, and it's not on the column right here. It's kind of between the center stack and the center console here. And it frees up some space down low to put some stuff like cell phone or CDs or something like that. We have plenty of cup holders. You notice we have cup holders here. We have cup holders in all four doors. Plenty of little storage cubbies. There's a little storage space here. And above all, overall, some really fine detailing and attention to fit and finish is clear when you look at the gaps in the materials and all the fit and finish of all the instrument panel parts and all the interior parts. And it really sends a message of quality and attention to detail. And further, things like the glove box door, this is damped, so it feels real nice. The sunglass door, that's damped real nice too. Things like the grab handles here, that's got a real nice damped feel to it. And a lot of attention has been paid to the interior of the Ronto. And let's take a look at the back seat and see what that's all about. First of all, again, this is the third row seat version, so it includes a sliding second row seat. The second row is split 60-40, and it slides fore aft so that you can get into the back seat, which, frankly, is quite comfortable. Now, I'm 5'10", and I could sit back here. Probably don't want to go, you know, hundreds of miles, but it isn't claustrophobic by any means. Also, when we're back here, you notice we have some more storage cubbies in the quarter trim here. We put stuff in there. There's also two more cup holders for third row seat occupants. Curtain airbags that go all the way back to the third row passenger. Let me hop out here. And here's this, you know, sliding function that we talked about on the third or the second row seat, so it slides fore aft about a foot. Other details too, including the cup holders in the rear door. And again, this being the EX, it has a metallic finish to the door handles right here, which is a little upscale feel. And again, getting in and out is not a problem at all because of the hip joint. More cup holders. And this car also has factory standard active headrest for the front seat occupants, which helps in a rear-ending collision to help the prevent whiplash. And if I may, one more time, you'll notice that the door opening on this car is huge. In fact, we went and we measured a variety of minivans and utility vehicles and other sedans from a couple different dimensions. And this door opening is one of the largest door openings in the industry. And we want to tout that because a lot of our target buyers are young couples and starting young families. So they'll be putting a child seat in the back seat. So it's real easy for a mother to place the child seat back here. And two, if she wanted to, she could move the seat to a location so that she could place the baby in the back seat, in the child seat, and then tend to it as needed from the front seat. So that's really handy. And finally, when we're closing the door and looking at the vehicle from the outside, the manufacturing, the tolerances on this vehicle are remarkable. If you look at the gaps between the doors and these kinds of little details, the fit and finish is truly remarkable. And that about sums it up.